Good morning. Today we discuss about the different methods for the controlling of the nematode. The plant parasitic nematodes can be controlled by several methods. The nematode control aims to improve the growth, quality and yield of the crop by keeping the nematode population below the economical threshold level. There are some different methods like a regulatory control method, cultural method, physical control, biological control and chemical control. Then first one is a regulatory control. Regulatory control of pests and diseases is a legal enforcement of measure to prevent them from the spreading or having spread from the multiplication sufficiently to become the intolerably troublesome. And there is some principles of regulatory control. They involve the enacting quarantine in exclusive the nematodes from the entering into the or which not infested in order to avoid the spread of the nematode. The quarantine principle are traditionally employed to restrict the movement of infected plant material and contaminate the soil into state or other countries. Any country maintain elaborated organization to the interrupt the plant shipment containing the nematodes and other pests. Disease and contaminant plant material may be treated to kill the nematode or the their entry may be avoided in one country to another country. The plant quarantine in India, the Destructive Insect and Pest Act 1940 was passed the government by the government of India, which restrict the introduction of exotic pest and disease into the country from the abroad side. The Agriculture Pest and Disease Act of the various states prevent the interstate spread of the pest within the country. The rules permit the plant protection advisor to government of the India or any authorized officer to undertake the inspection of the treatments. There are some nematode like Globuda rostrochinensis, potato cyst nematode and the Radinavellensis cocophilus, the ring nematode of coconut. There are some domestic nematodes. The domestic quarantine regulation have been also imposed to restrict the movement of the potato both for seed and tuber purpose in order to prevent the spread of the potato cyst nematode from the Tamil Nadu to other state of the India. The second one is the cultural method. The cultural nematode control method are the ergonomical principle in order to minimize the nematode problems in the crops. The first one is the selection of the healthy and healthy seed material. When we want to select the healthy and mature seed in plant propagated by vegetative means. We can eliminate nematode by selecting the vegetative parts or plants of the healthy plants. The golden nematode of potato, the burrowing, spiral and lesion nematodes of the banana can be eliminated by the selected nematode free plant material. We select the nematode free plant material for the growing the new crops. The wheat seed gall nematodes and rice wheat tip nematode can be controlled by the using the nematode free seeds. Next one is the adjusting the time of the planting. Nematode life cycle is just most depend on the temperature, atmosphere and humidity. The adjusting time of the planting helps to avoid the nematode damage. In some cases, the crops may be planted in the winter when the soil temperature is very low. At that time, the nematode cannot be active their system at low temperature. And early potato and sugar beets grow in soil during the cold season and accept the cyst nematode during the cold season and damage since the nematode are not that much the active to damage the crop during the cold season. Next one is the fallowing. The leaving the field without the cultivation is preferably after the plowing the help to expose the nematodes to the sunlight and nematode die due to the starvation without the host plant. And this method is not economically just used for the harvesting. Now the next one is deep summer plowing. In the summer season, the during the onset of the summer, infested the field is plowing with the disc plow as the export to hot sun, which in the turn the enhance the soil temperature, increase the soil temperature, and then because of the high temperature, the nematodes are killed for the raising the small nursery beds for the vegetable crops like a tomato, and brinjal, the seed beds can be prepared during summer season and covered with the polythene sheets, which enhance the soil temperature up to 5 to 10 degree centigrade, while which kills the nematode in the seed bed. And this nematode is very effective to this method is very effective, and the nematode free seedling can be raised by this solarization method. Next one is the manuring. The raising of green manure crops and the addition of the more amount of the farmyard manure, oil cakes and neem and castor, the press mud and poultry manure, it is the enrich the soil and further the encouragement of the development of the precidious nematode like a monocell species and also other the nematode antagonistic microbes in the soil, which checks the parasitic nematode in the field. Next one is the flooding. The flooding can be adopted where there is a enormous availability of the water. The flooding is generally used in a rice crop. The under the submerged condition, the anaerobic condition developed in the soil which kills the nematode by the asphyxiation. The chemical result the nematode such as the hydrogen sulfide and ammonia are released in the flooded condition which kills the nematode. Now next one is the trap cropping. Generally two crop are grown in the same field is called trap cropping, out of the which one crop is highly susceptible to nematode and the nematode attacks on the susceptible crop, and then by carefully planning the susceptible crop can be grown first and then remove and burn. Then the main crop are except from the nematode damage, and cowpea is a highly susceptible crop, can be grown in the first and then remove and the burn. And the cowpea is a highly susceptible for the root knot nematode, and the crop can be destroyed before the nematodes matures. Now the antagonistic crops. Some antagonistic crops have a sub chemical compounds in the from all over the or all the part of the plants, like a marigold. The certain crops like a mustard, marigold and neem have a chemical or alkaloid as root exudator which repels or suppress the plant parasitic nematode. In marigold the plant have a alpha 39 and bithynyl compounds are present throughout the plant, the root to shoot tip, and this chemical kills the nematode. And in mustard, allyl isothiocyanate, and in a pangola grass, the pyrocyticol are present which kills the nematode. And such enemy plants can be grown along with the main crops or include the in the crop rotation for the control of the nematodes. Now the removal and destruction of the infected plant. The early detection or of infested plant are removed to help to reduce the nematode spreading to one field to another field. Now after the harvest, the stable or the stable of the infected plant are be removed, and in generally tobacco plant the root system is left in the field after harvest. This will serve the inoculum or the next season crop. The similar to the angiosters, the nematode remains in the left out the stable in the field after harvest of the rice grain. Now the some use of the resistant variety. Some crop variety are very resistant to nematode, which are used in a generally used in the field. The nematode resistant variety have been reported from the time to time in different crops. They use the resistant variety is a very effective method to avoid the nematode damage. Like Nematex, Hisar, Lalit and Atkinson are the different after variety of the tomato which are resistant to Melodogyna ignotita, and the tomato the potato variety, the Khurfi Sarna, is a resistant to Globular Rostrochinensis. Now the physical control. It is a very easy method for in the laboratory area by exposing the nematode by heat, irradiation or asthmatic pressure. Now the first is the heat treatments of the soil. The sterilization of soil along in the steam in the practice in the soil use in generally greenhouse, bed house, seed bed, and also for the small area, but not for use in the large area. The insects, viruses and nematodes, bacteria, fungi are killed by the steam sterilization. In such a cases the steam is introduced in the lower level of the soil by means of perforated iron pipes buried in the soils, and the soil surface need the cover during the steaming operation. The plastic sheet are also used for the covering for increasing the more temperature. This is a figure of the soil sterilization in the field. Now the hot water treatment, in the hot water treatment also same as the steam steam treatment. When used instead of the steam, when we can also use the hot hot water. The hot water treatment is commonly used for the controlling the nematode. The prior to the planting of the seed material such as a banana comb, onion bulb and tuber seeds are and roots of the seedling can be dipped in the hot water at 50 to 55 degree centigrade for 10 minutes and then planting. Now the irradiation. Irradiation is generally used for the controlling the cyst nematodes. The expose the 20,000 gamma contents only the dead eggs and 40,000 gamma expose the eggs to lose their content. And Dietylenchus micellifagus is in mushroom. The compost expose due to the gamma rays between the 48,000 to 96,000. The inactivate of the nematode and UV light also used for the killing the nematodes. Now the osmotic pressure, the Feder in 1916 the reported that the 100% of nematode mortality when the sucrose or dextrose were added into nematode infested soil at the rate 1 to 5% by the weight, but this method are not using for the practically or and economically uses. Now the washing process, generally we can generally for the propagation we can use the tuber crops, tubers, bulbs and other planting material. The first we properly wash their planting material and then carefully washing the such a planting material the help to avoid the nematodes in the spreading in the new planting field. The washing apparatus for the cleaning the potato and sugar beet tubers which are commercially developed and are being the used in the many countries. Now the seed cleaning, the modern mechanical seed cleaning method have been the developed to remove the seed galls from the normally healthy wheat seed. Now next one is the ultrasonic. Ultrasonic have a little effect on the heterogeneous species, but this is not using the practically feasible. Now the biological control. The first one is the predaceous nematodes. The predaceous nematodes have a specialized open specialized structure in their body to control the other harmful nematode. Like a stoma arm with the teeth to catch and swallow the plant parasitic nematodes. In the addition of the organic amendments that help to encourage the multiplication of the predaceous nematodes such as a monococcus species and other genera like a diplogaster species and trifla species are come under the group of the predaceous nematode. And there are some predaceous fungi. In predaceous fungi, there are special type of they control the trapping fungi and endozoic fungi. The first is a trapping fungi. The nematode trapping fungi have an adhesive network and the sticky knobs in her body structure. The produced by the mycelium to capture the plant parasitic nematode. The nematode trapper the group of as a fellow. First in the sticky branches, the fungal mycelia have a short lateral branches and they anastomose to form the loops and the nematode trap in the loops. The sticky network. Next one is the mycelium skulls around the anastomose with the similar branches and these loops to produce the complex three-dimensional structure in her body in their body and the adhesive surface of the network help to hold the nematodes. Now the sticky knob. The small spherical or subspherical lobes are present one or two cells lateral. I feel the only the terminal knobs is sticky to hold the nematodes. Now the construction ring, the short hyphal branches curls the back end on the itself and anastomus on the forming ring. The when the nematode enter the ring and the contact in the inner walls, the ring walls ring cells the bulge inward the filling and the lumen the ring and the kills the nematodes. Now the non-construction ring, the trap is a form the similar to the construction ring. The ring becomes ineffective structure and kills the nematode. Next one is the endozoic fungi. The endogenous fungi is a usually enter the nematode by the germ tubes and the penetrate the cuticle from the sticky spores. The fungal hyphae ramify the throughout the nematode's body and absorb the content and the multiply and they hyphae then they emerge from the dead nematode. Now parasitic fungi, there is some use of the fungi to act parasitic to control the nematode. The parasitic fungi is a particularly effective to against the Meloidogyne heterodera, Rotichinus, Rotichellus and Tylenchellus. The fungus attack the egg as the deposited in the group of the mass and to control the nematode. Now some bacteria are used for the controlling the harmful nematodes. Like a recent study has shown the influence of the introduced the microbial antagonist in controlling the plant parasitic nematode. The seed treatment with the Pseudomonas fluorescens has been found to reduce the cyst nematodes, and the rhizobacteria like a Bacillus cereus, Burkholderia, Capensia are were found to control the effect of the Melogradina incognita in tomato and banana. There are some and generally in chemical there is some used to nematicide for the controlling the nematode. The nematicide is a defined substances or mixture of the substances used for the killing, repelling or otherwise the prevailing the plant parasitic nematode. The Kuhn in 1881 they first tested the carbon disulfide to control the sugar beet nematode in Germany, and he could not get the encourage the result. And there are some other scientists who found the different nematicides. There are some important nematicide like ethyl dibromide, dibromochlorobenzene, there with their content or different content and their trade name. In the ethyl dibromide, the trade name is bromofume and dowfume. Second is a dibromochlorobenzene. Third one is a didyl mixture. Then methyl bromide or bromomethane. Next is the chloropyrifos, the chlorophyllis, phenamiphos, exploratize, forate, carbofurine, methomyl, oxymyl. And there so last, the resistance variety. The use of the resistance variety to provide an effective and economical and friendly means to nematode control. There are some of the crops with their resistant variety. The first one is the tomato, the root knot nematode, the against the root knot nematode, the resistant variety is a PNR7, NT3, NT12 and SR Lalit. In chili crops, the against the root knot nematode, the resistant variety NP46, Pusa Jwala, Mohini. In cow pea, against the root knot nematode, the resistant variety is a GAU, Gujarat Agricultural University is a one. In mung bean, the root knot against the root knot nematode, the resistant variety is ML30 and ML62. And last one is in potato, the resistant variety against the potato cyst nematode is a Khurpi Swarna and Khurpi Giri rice. Okay, thank you.